Okay. Beautiful, my cam is on. Not there. Like this. Az attık da Davut. Okay. Here we are. Simamız uzaqdadır deyəndə. I think. Okay, Davut. Okay. Go back. We go to audio. We take it down to 35 then. Is it better now? Voice check. But there is no music. Come on. Okay. Is it better now? Okay, Ben is a good answer. Alright people, we start to play campaign, we wait for people to gather up, and then I will explain why I picked Terminator Resistant Complete Edition, optimized for Xbox Series X. I'm gonna play normal. So, we start. This game has been produced by a company called Tion. So this is a semi-Polish development company. This company is famous for producing games based on the IPs from 80s, such as they did Rambo 10 years ago, they did Terminator. Let's see the cutscene.
On August 29th, 1997, Skynet, a computer system built to protect us, became self-aware. It viewed humanity as a threat to its existence and decided to act. Judgment Day, as we eventually called it, marked the beginning of the war against the machines. Skynet attacks happened almost daily, but the attack that happened on that day was like nothing we'd seen before.
This is pretty much what's going to happen to us in the future, guys. AI attacking on humanity, that's the point. I'm checking my cam, my computer, sometimes just to see the comments.
Where are the others? Where's the rest of the resistance?
Where's the rest of the resistance?
I don't know.
We have four people, we will start. Oh.
No.
Second.
No, no.
Okay, doesn't look bad. Doesn't look bad at all. This is T-100, I guess. We're gonna crawl for a while.
I'm through.
Cyber perspective.
I know who you are.
Okay, another cutscene. Okay, here we are, guys.
There's an evacuation point on the other side of town. You need to get there.
So we need to go there. Alright, I guess we can start. Let's have a look around. Graphics are not bad. It's good, it's enticing. Looks quite decent. Developed by Unreal Engine. Four. Let's look at the sky. The sound design is not bad either, so we can go on. Game had mixed reviews at the beginning, and later on it became,
as soon as you get down the street, turn right and run as fast as you can.
It became quite a fan favorite and created a little bit cult following among the Terminator fans. Here are the Terminators. We go right. It's pretty good, I would say. Feels like a real Terminator. Colors are good. Gonna have a look at the Terminators just for a fun. Where are they? Where are the Terminators? Here they are coming. Fuckers. Okay, so gifted a sub to someone. What did you do? Hello, Elias. Someone gifted a subscription. I think I died while checking for a subscription. No, it's still on.
I am
still on. We carry on. Mama, я про тебя не забыл. Okay, so let's get out of way. Pretty standard medical kit. Okay, trade resources. I'm gonna take it all. Melee. This is why. Alright, I'm gonna move slowly and start with the discussion of Mario Kassar. So today's topic is Mario Kassar. Sometimes I'm gonna look at the left, guys, just to see the chat, because Xbox, unlike PlayStation, doesn't show you the real chat box, which is bad, which distracts. Considering the way I'm streaming, PlayStation is much better option. But I bought my first camera as promised on Twitch money. This is second hand MI100 or whatever. By the way, how is camera? Okay, so voice check. If there is a voice issue, please let me know. So basically, Mario Kassar is a Lebanese-American film producer whose name, Ultravision Goggles, to say in the mess with the walls. Okay. So Mario Kassar became kind of trademark. Here are the Terminators. So he became a trademark, he became synonym to blockbusters in 80s and 90s. How it happened? Let's start from the very beginning. So basically, Mario Kassar has started. Yes, he is Lebanese, Daftan. So Mario Kassar started as a small producer in 70s, and then, so we have Flashlight as well. Then eventually he partnered up with a guy called Andrew Weiner. They bought the rights to the novel of the David Murrell. So it is a book about ex-Vietnam soldier who comes to US, who wants to get a decent job. So this is a critique on Nixon's reign. This is the critique why it ever happened, why we went to Vietnam, all the communism related stuff and so on. Let me check the Sophie Salam there. Aleyküm Salam. Okay, I'm not going to reveal identity of the Seiforsh. Let me just grab mobile for a second, guys. So, Mario Casar decides to team up with another filmmaker called Andrew Vina. Basically, Vina and Casar get the rights for a film of the David Morrell's book. In this book, there is a crazy guy who is coming back from Vietnam. He kills a lot of people in one of the villages. He lost all of his friends after the war. Some got crazy, some did suicide. This guy is the only one left. I guess you can guess about whom we are talking. And eventually at the end, the guy is killed by one of his superiors in the climax of the battle. Yes, this guy is John Rambo. And if you read the novel, I read the novel after watching the film. Novel is extremely cruel, there is a lot of blood, there is a cruelty, and John Rambo is not a guy who cries at the end in the novel. So, detection indicator, okay, so I should be careful. Basically, they buy the rights, and second thing they have to do is to get a right person to star in the film. And back then, Sylvester Stallone is becoming a trademark. He just little spider. He just become a worldwide star after the Rocky, because he wrote the Rocky, he acted in the Rocky, and Rocky became a film getting an Oscar for Best Picture. So Stallone is a right fit. Where are you, fucking spider? Stallone is a right fit to get on the board. They agree with Stallone, they make the film, they make the initial cut. Hello? After the screening, a lot of people say that why we killed the Rambo? So they reshoot some scenes and they say, okay, in book Rambo died, but in film he's not gonna die. Why? Because everyone falls in love with softer version of the Rambo. And secondly, this is Hollywood and we need sequels. If we make money, we're gonna go for a sequel. Oh. That's exactly what Mario Casar and Andrew Vine is doing. They reshoot the film and then they go for... Okay, little brother, we need to save the guy. And then Rambo makes a lot of money. It becomes critically well, it becomes commercially very good, earns around 100 millions. Okay, should I protect him or quit crying, kid? Any suggestions? Okay, Hajiev, quit crying or I will protect you. I give the solution to you. Yeah, graphics are good. Protect. Okay, I'll protect you, kid.
But staying here is not an option. I'll protect you and your sister, okay?
Okay, I'll protect you, kiddo. So Rambo is done, and then they make a sequel. They bring James Cameron itself to write the script for Rambo 2. Rambo 2 is considered to be a worse film among the Rambos, but it's still a good blockbuster for 80s. They make Rambo 2, and eventually Mario Casar becomes a synonymous with a producer who knows how to make money. And what he did, I'm gonna give you an incredible story. In 1991, during the Cannes, so basically they are
this way.
When Cannes are there, Mario Casar gets all the stars into the one plane. They fly to Cannes, Sylvester Stallone, Arnold Schwarzenegger, Steven Seagal, Jean-Claude Van Damme, Dolph Lundgren, everyone. By that time he was producing Universal Soldier, Rip of Terminator, starring Van Damme and Lundgren. And what he did when they arrived at Cannes, I read it in Nick Simoleon's The Last Action Hero book and then Googled it. They did a big fireworks and Terminator 2 logo appeared in the sky. That's the only time when Khan was that much popular, that much mainstream. And he managed to have Sly and Arnold same time entering the hall. And Sylvester Stallone became angry because everyone was going in direction of Arnold, but it was the only guy until the Expendables who managed to have two biggest stars of Hollywood under same umbrella. Then he made Terminator 2, one of the best sci-fis ever. That's why we are playing this game. He spent around 30 million on that film just to make it on incredibly high level for a time. Terminator became the most expensive film ever made in 1992. Okay, I have to kill this fucker. Okay, he doesn't see me. That's very stupid. They have so many sensors and they don't see us. So he makes Terminator, then he makes Basic Instinct. By the way, Sharon Stone was at that Cannes festival as well. So Mario Casar is making incredible money. But what is happening next? That's interesting. The guy becomes so much obsessed with his producing talents. Let me check the chat. I'm not best person about the kids. Okay, Pervis, you are not best person about the kids. So that Mario Casar becomes so much obsessed with his talents, he says, all right then, I'm gonna do whatever I want and whatever I make, it's gonna make money. That's how he makes a mistake. They make a film called Cutthroat Island about pirate adventure. Film lost his studio, which was called Karolka Pictures, around 45 million. They declared a bankruptcy and that's how Mario Casar is slowly getting vanished out of the stage. Later on, of course, he gets 1 million closing fee from the Karolko and still produce some films, but it's not the same. He produced Terminator 3 again with Andrew Wiener. Let me talk to the guy.
You're from the Resistance. Thank you for making sure that Jennifer and Patrick got here safe.
Are you the guy I spoke to on the radio?
I don't think so. I haven't been able to reach anybody for a while now.
This Ryan guy looks like Danny Glover a bit.
Colin wants us to go, but I don't know how I feel about leaving anyone behind.
Guys, is safe for Sheer, whom we have got.
You said yourself that you heard someone on the radio. There could be other people out there. Don't you think somebody should go
graphics
and look
are
for
good.
Them? I mean,
there is also ray tracing in the game. And you can feel it. We should leave or search for the survivors. Okay, I'll search for the survivors.
Good, I'll get the bus ready. Before you go, talk to Erin. She might be able to get you a med kit.
All right, we are getting med kits from the Erin. So, okay, I have better weapon now. How I shift? I shift like this. I am selecting it with A. Oh, where is my weapon? What happened to it? Anyway, so this is Erin. She's gonna
Ryan
give us med kits.
Med kit for me.
He still makes Terminator 3 with Andrew Wiener. Later on, he creates C2 Studio to make Terminator 4, unless Terminator rights being sold. And after that, Casar is like history. He invested 100 million into in Singaporean. Yes, I need it. Singaporean studio called Infinite Entertainment in 2014, and then he made another joint venture with Bricktop Studios, another Asian American production entertainment company. But still, the guy is not here anymore. He lost the rights to Terminator, he lost rights to Rambo. Basically, he became very ordinary producer. But why it happened? Now let's analyze this. The things which were being done by Mario Casar was not something skyrocketing, not a rocket science, not something which is a star level marketing. Of course, he did the Cannes, he spent lots of money on Terminator, but Terminator 1 already became cult by 1988, 1989. And anyone who would produce it under the creative control of the James Cameron pretty much would make the same film. That is why it was not the right decision to think that my marketing is gonna work. He was always looking for star power, but in 90s action genre started to die slowly. Why? Too much stupid films, too many explosions, and people became more and more skewed to see less action, more events within a film. It's not that Chuck Norris film was appealing to Chuck Norris film was appealing to the viewers. No, not anymore. How are we gonna kill this fucker. He sees me over there, I guess I'm gonna shoot. Okay, Chuck Norris films not appealing anymore. Standard actions not appealing anymore. So Kassar's strategy to become like number one in action genre was going to die in any case. He was too assured that this genre is going to live forever. And there was also another factor. He didn't calculate star power of Arnold or Sly in 90s. Their power together with the genre started to diminish. In 90s, Arnold Schwarzenegger made 6-7 films. None of them were as successful as the old films done by Arnold. Not like, oh my god, there is a big spider. None of them were as successful as old Conan, Commandos, or old Terminators. Schwarzenegger was dying, Sylvester Stallone was an extremely stupid guy. He made so many bad films that most of them are considered among the worst films ever made. So eventually, Mario Kassar's star power strategy was dying. After the Basic Instinct, he actually made Basic Instinct. He managed to get Michael Douglas on the board with Sharon Stone. Sharon Stone was just a young girl back then, but we all know that film, we all know that scene. After that one, he went to Showgirls with no star power. So he trusted Paul Verhoeven, the guy who made Basic Instinct, and he went with no marketing and no star power for Showgirls. That one bankrupted. And after that, he made his biggest mistake. He thought that Gina Davis is a star. She was starring in The Fly, Thelma and Louise, and other films. She is a very good actress. She's an Oscar holder, but considering a woman as a sole star for 50 million film in 90s is a very big mistake. And that's how he started to lose it, No marketing. And his notorious reputations made him one of the guy who was like not really appealing to Hollywood folk anymore. And Mario Kassar ended. But what happened? The other producers like Dino De Laurentiis, Jerry Bruckheimer learned on the mistakes done by Mario Kassar. And that's how in the 90s there was a huge boom in cinematic marketing. Posters, a lot of interviews, a lot of audio commentaries, how they are being made, and first of all, star power, the amount for actors getting, started to decrease to keep the budget of the film. That's where Mario Kassar failed. That's how he ended up almost in nothing. But Mario Kassar's production style is a trademark for Hollywood. If you go to Kevin Feige, the guy who made Marvel Cinematic Universe, Kevin Feige pretty much used the same production techniques done by Mario Kassar. Okay, we have the good story. Now we can select the director. This is exactly what was done by Mario Kassar. He was not looking for incredible filmmakers, except James Cameron probably, but for a good story, for a good production rules, and he was bringing a relative filmmakers to make good films. So he made Total Recall with Paul Verhoeven. He trusted Paul Verhoeven, but the project itself was very appealing. He knew how to work. He made Cliffhanger with Rennie Harlan. Rennie Harlan is a Finnish director who just made Die Hard 2, another film which was a cash cow in 90s starring Bruce Willis. This is another topic. And these filmmakers are not distinctive. They are just there. They are good, but they are single-handedly being under the umbrella of the Mario Kassar. So that strategy is paved the way for MCU. This is exactly what Kevin Feige has been doing for 15 years. And maybe that's how Kevin Feige is also losing his power, his dominance as a blockbuster producer today. Because after a time, it doesn't work anymore. You cannot keep to the simple formula of cash cow at the marketing. This is not good. By the way, nobody tells me that my joystick is seeing on the screen. Okay, I think it's better. Let me see the chat. Pervis is not a best person. Okay. So Mario Kassar failed very bad. And I'm telling you, Kevin Feige is gonna fail in exact same way. another producer, Neil H. Moritz. He made a lot of action films, Fast and Furious. He made Matrixes and many more. He's having the exact same issue. What you should do, you should go to Jerry Bruckheimer style. Now Jerry Bruckheimer knows what to produce and how to produce. He learned from Mario Casar and he learned from his mistakes. If you look at the Jerry Bruckheimer, the guy produced Pirates of Caribbean, made tons of money on that one. Even The Last Pirates made some money, Dead Man Tells No Tale. Although it wasn't the best one, obviously not the best one among five, but still profitable. He made Pearl Harbor, he made Armageddon, and many, many more. So what you have to do, you have to play with the market. No producer is above the market when you are producing the blockbusters. There are the rules, and no matter who you are, you should stick to the plan. If you go beyond that scope, you're gonna fail. I'm gonna give another example. There is a studio called A24. They are very good. They are making artistic films, but recently they started to transit into big budget films. And what happened? They failed. You know why? Because you are an independent studio. You cannot make 30-40 million films and without any substantial marketing expect these films to rack up their costs. Now that ain't gonna happen anymore. Because look at around, guys, the level of the content. Wait, he meant then. Okay, we are talking about Mr. Hajiev. I mean, look at the market. We have so many content. If I ask, say, Fosh what he's going or she's going to watch, the response can vary. Only this week, Netflix released so many new things. Amazon released new film. Apple is releasing Argyle, which is another topic. I mean, Disney released Echo, new Marvel Cinematic Universe tie-in series, everything. And with simple making a film that, okay, I'm A24, I make good films. Of course you do. We know you are a trademark, you made amazing films, but where's the marketing? Where are the market rules? No, they're not there. This is the mistake coming from the Mario Casar, because he was amazing producer. He didn't care about the market rules and he failed. Kevin Feige, right now, he needs to adjust himself into the market or he's gonna fail. I'm gonna give another example who is very, very, okay, more survivors. Who is very, very bright persona. His name is Jon Favreau. The guy made, okay, Armored Spider. Fuck. I'm gonna kill this one. So, Jon Favreau made Iron Man, he made Zathura, he made Cowboys and Aliens, which bankrupted very, very badly due to the bad release seasoning and due to bad marketing with Daniel Craig and Indiana Jones, Harrison Ford, with Olivia Wilde. But all of them are good films. But what? Jon, I'm out of ammo. Wait a second. Get off! Okay, let me kill this guy. It's really tough to talk and to shoot. I'm not doing it bad. I'm in general good at shooters, but graphics are really good, guys. And I watched the original release of the game. It wasn't this much good when they released it. Right. So, amount is crazy. He meant the better. Yes, Seifosh, amount is crazy. You're in. Basically, what Jon Favreau did, I loved his strategy. The guy was working for Disney, as you know, Star Wars, Marvel, everything is under big democratic company called Disney, which is monopolizing the market. They bought Fox as well, even Avatar itself. Some Terminators are with Disney right now. But what Jon Favreau did, he made a good decision. He was seeing the recent Star Wars progress. Okay, they made three films. All of them grossed over 1 billion. Actually, four films, including Rogue One and three latest episodes. But what else happened? The other film, Han Solo, lost around 150 million. Why? Because there wasn't a need for new Han Solo. You don't need to recast anyone. People don't want it. We want old Han Solo. Disney knew it. Jon Favreau was one of the pivotal guys saying that, okay, we don't need to go for old products, let's create something new within the universe, and they created Mandalorian. Then Jon Favreau led the process of the Ahsoka creation and other Star Wars spin-offs, Book of, what was the Book of Boba Fett, and now new things are coming. He was also initiating idea to do the Andor Star Wars prequel to the Rogue One, prequel to the prequel of the New Hope. But that's how market works. What Jon Favreau's leadership for Star Wars does, they analyze everything, amount is crazy, as Seyfosh is stating, and they bring the best product to the market. There is a need, there is a product, it may not earn 1 billion, but it will earn us 200 million, guaranteed, and that's what Jon Favreau did. That's why Jon Favreau is like new trademark how to produce a good content on a blockbuster level, and I do really adore the job done by this guy. Let me mention that he also made Jungle's Book, he made latest Lion King. The guy knows what to do to make a good sellable product. He's an artist, but also he's a very, very, very good producer. He knows the needs of the market, and he's never rushing to put a product on the table. That's pretty much it about Mario Kassar. Now I'm gonna keep playing the game, guys. If you have any questions, anything to discuss, just let me know. Let me check the chat very quickly, and I will finish the game like 30 more minutes. Anything to be discussed, please bring on, happy to answer. And meanwhile, I'm gonna enjoy the game Terminator, which is associated with Mario Kassar. Look at the weather, look at the graphs, look at the dust, it's amazing. Fabrics, by the way, how was the camera? Do you like my ugly face? I guess Seyfosh doesn't, because Seyfosh is fed up with this face, but that's another discussion. By no means I'm trying to expose her identity. Alright, we go, we grab the stuff. Lockpins is back. What I shall find? Metal scraps to open the lockpin. Okay, crafting table. That's good, that's something close to Last of Us Soul. You craft something, you use it. That's smart, actually. I like the fact that they integrated action adventure with some exploration factor that makes game a good. Okay, what I have to do? A good hybrid of action, adventure, a little bit intellectual effort, and here we have got a weapon, a big gun.
All this for us?
Okay, there's another guy. He looks like a cyborg.
Yeah, startle you.
Seyfosh, I feel like we are having content poisoning, how much stuff are created, available over the world. Content poisoning. What do you want? Are you always such an asshole?
Are you always such an asshole?
I like this answer.
Now that I think about it, I guess I am.
Thanks for being honest,
since
Colin.
Since we're stuck here, I figured I'll go see if anything's creeping around the corner. I hear that you're looking for the resistance.
Okay.
Where I'm heading, they used to have an outpost. I wouldn't mind
that
while I'm out there. So what do you say? Buddies?
Buddies?
Talk to Ryan and see if he needs anything. I'm moving out now. Let's meet at the bridge. And don't make me wait.
Have you befriended this guy already? Without any effort? I just called you an asshole. Why you don't do anything substantial? Ah, stupid guy. Alright. This game chronologically happens in parallel to events of Terminator 1. So I'm not sure, did we send, what was the name of the guy, Kyle Reeves, back in time yet? But this is future, this is after apocalypse, and this is a good take on the overall lore of the Terminator.
Hey, thanks for earlier.
Farid Bey, kameranın yerini değişebilirsiniz. How, David, what do you want me to do? I can lift her up a bit.
Patrick's been through a lot, you know.
Is it better?
I just wish I could find something that would take his mind off all this.
I don't know.
Anyway, that's all I wanted to say.
I can do like this. Is it better? Okay, I can come closer for you, Davut. I need to establish the place of the camera. What happened to your father?
What happened to him?
I think it's good.
He protected us from a tin can. We were able to sneak out, but he had no chance.
For me, camera is
when
fine.
I back,
better.
He was lying there, dead on the floor.
So, stories happening
sorry,
in parallel to Terminator 1. There is also a little bit RPG exploration element. You have the choices and these choices. I'm not sure that
were there any resistance
they are
Pasadena?
Affecting your the story substantially. Not like Witcher or any other game. Not like, I don't know, Quantic Dream games.
That maybe we
but
were safe,
there are
so
some effects for sure
anymore.
On the game.
But
we will see
we
once we explore the content. Okay. But graphics are very good. There are some lagging when it's rendering, but it is good. Some look, there are some rendering issues for sure, but overall it has been done by quite a mid-level publisher. I like the way they worked. Okay, Davut, you have too many needs. No goings, number one going streamer. Who is that? Mr. Shirin. Thank you, sir. Glowing streamer. Don't forget to subscribe. By the way, guys, we're gonna do a giveaway of some fictional books. I'm gonna share the conditions of the giveaway. Books will be sent only streamers from Azerbaijan and UK this time. We're gonna do some interactive thing with Instagram. And if you are a Twitch user, you will have, instead of one, five chances to get a lottery, and your book will be delivered to you within a month if you are in Azerbaijan and within a week if you are in UK. We will have three books, all of them are secondhand. Random chosen books, but I hope you're gonna enjoy it. The idea is to extend the number of viewers, or maybe I will increase the numbers to five, because I'm gonna put content on YouTube as well about traveling and how it's affecting our conscience, one of SafeForge's favorite topic, and then we will see how it goes on. Too many new quests for Ryan. Okay, we run. This is, I guess, LA. I need to, so Rules of Survival, Joy-Con Warehouse District, Naruto, Travel to Warehouse District, Travel to Warehouse District. Evil Travel to Warehouse District. So, I know, David, I know. Bizim tüm dirsen. Let's carry on. With Pacific Division destroyed, nothing stands in the way of the Annihilation Land, but mine just got so it's like diary of our character, his name is Rivers. Outpost that. By the way, this studio lately made new RoboCop game. Chronologically happening between second and third RoboCop. It's called Rogue City. And I heard that it is pretty good. Okay, this is how I get my stuff. So this is pretty good, same engine, even some movements of RoboCop are similar to the ones in Terminator, but good decent game, good use of Unreal Engine 5. If you are fan of retro sci-fis, that can be a good option. It's not really expensive, it's just out, but there are already some discounts on internet. You can use that one, you can play it on PC or on any of the consoles. I don't tend to play on PC, but I think easiest way for you to do a part-time game is PC. Okay, red eye, we have to aim to the red eye. Daftan, is it better? Okay, we carry on. Guys, Mario Kassar story is almost done. You are free to go. You are more than welcome to stay and enjoy the rest of the game. And if you have any questions, so I have to shoot for red eye. Okay, okay. Ah, I'm detected. Fuck. But AI here is a bit stupid, honestly. Look, AI is very stupid. That's, I think, great hit, one of the drawbacks so far. Robots are extremely stupid. Okay, we killed it? No, we didn't. He's still there, he's still there. I'm gonna kill you, fucking fucker. I'm gonna kill you with melee. Okay, I could go for a gun. I decided to go for melee and it worked out. Some chips, some electric parts. Good game, good game. Okay, we go further. World building is good. It gives you a vibe of Terminator 4 Salvation, made by McGee. If you watch that game, that film, you will remember the scenes with Marcus Wright, played by Sam Worthington. Fuck off. Okay, I'm getting better at this. So it's pretty much looking like Terminator Salvation, and in my opinion, Salvation was not a bad film. If you ask me, all the Terminators are pretty good. They are fine to watch. Okay, some of them are one-timers, pretty much last four films, except the first and second one. But after the second one, there are like three different takes. Actually, there are four different takes. And none of them are related. You have four options to watch it. If you ask me, for me the best case will be Terminator 1, 2, and then to go for Terminator Genesis. Why I liked Genesis? Because it was return of the Arnold to the franchise. It was done nicely. There is Emilia Clarke. There is alternative timeline over there. It's good. You should watch it. Reviews are not really good. And it didn't make a lot of money, that's why they rebooted again for the fourth time. But it is a good film, it is a fine film. And Arnold Schwarzenegger, after going to another acting school, after becoming a governor of the California, improved his acting drastically. The guy knows how to act now. Okay, I cannot leave the area. So Terminator Genesis, if you are making your trilogy of the Terminators, go for first one, second one, and then Genesis. Second option would be to go to first one, second one, and then the Dark Fate, because it's not bad either. It has direct involvement of James Cameron, although when it bankrupted, Cameron started to bitch about the project. He called it shit, and now he's writing another Terminator. Oh my god, James Cameron. That's enough, bro. That's totally enough. But it is not a bad film. Third option would be the Salvation. And the worst one will be the Rise of Machines. That film doesn't have the soul of the Terminator. John Connor is a very stupid guy. Okay, let's see. John Connor is a stupid guy in this one. Story doesn't work at all. So what I need to do? Rotate? Okay, that's it. John Connor is a very stupid guy. There is a Catherine Brewster. I like the inclusion of the female characters. There has always been some female leads in Terminator. James Cameron is one of the pioneers who entered female-centered blockbusters, starting with Sarah Connor. But Catherine Brewster in that film, that's awful character. That's awful playing. And film itself doesn't bring anything. If you haven't watched it, there will be a quick spoiler. You can miss next 10 seconds, but basically, okay, rotate it. Basically, Terminator 3 doesn't give you anything except some nice chase scenes. Christiana Walker as a TX is very good. This is the first female looking like Terminator. She's hot, she's acting well. Ruthless. She's taking on the Robert Patrick's T-1000 and making it much more violent, but overall this is not a good experience. Conversely, again, Genesis has everything, and another spoiler is here, and if you watch the trailer you know it, Genesis makes John Connor part of Skynet. I think that's one of the points, because Terminator story is a paradox. It's how Kyle Reeves went back in time, he becomes the father of the John Connor, he falls in love with Sarah Connor, he had to protect it, he even didn't know that he's the father of the John Connor, only John Connor from future knew, but that's the paradox itself. How you can do something like this without having a direct involvement with the things happening? I think maybe Skynet just created John Connor as one of their projects, and in real time future there wasn't John Connor at the end, it was part of the simulation done by Skynet, because otherwise, oh my god, I'm still having a problem with this locking. Otherwise this loop, this paradox would never started. It just keeps going over and over, and we have Sadomaso, we have new subscriber Sadomaso, thank you for joining. So without having an artificial intervention you cannot have this time loop. I guess I can also create a good podcast on this one. John Connor is the product of Skynet. Skynet just wanted to assess how a threat from future can affect us, and that's how they created John Connor. And all other John Connors coming after it are just variations of the Skynet's own creation. And in Terminator Genesis, John Connor is becoming like leading TX-3000 for the Terminators, for the Skynets, and he's hunting his own mother. Here's the paradox. If he kills the mother, he will never be born. If he's not born, he will never do the time travel. And at the end, how this all thing will be evolving? That's a paradox. That's why I always thought that Skynet is the creator of the John Connor. It's not even a person, John Connor, but this is ideology of John Connor happening over the period of time, and this is endless loop. Because there is no other explanation how this John Connor came to the life. Okay, there is a paradox, but there is always a start for a paradox. And if you ask me, Skynet is the root of the paradox. I crafted an item. We have new subscriber. We have good viewership. Guys, you are not really active on chats. Anything to add about the Skynet or whatsoever, please keep calm and add your thoughts. I love this process. Please be very aggressive about commenting how do I stream. As I promised, with first money we got this beautiful cam, and later on we will get more. After this month probably I'll get a camera for PlayStation 5, because PlayStation is a very ruthless company. Sony wants us to use only their products. It's £40 and right now I'm out of the budget. I spent £8 on this one, but it works perfectly fine for now. And I spent around £10 on charity. Thanks to you guys. Let us read the note about douchebag. Some douchebag came up with a bright idea to use the mannequins for da-da-da-da-da-da. It's fucked up if you ask me. I just don't like the idea. Me and Joker were keeping da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da. Okay, so this is practice, not nothing important. So we did a charity together with you guys. With all your subscriptions, I sent a little symbolic amount to one of the girls who is cerebrally paralyzed. She's from Azerbaijan. And second charity I'm gonna do, okay, it's locked from other side. I'm gonna open a charity here for Alzheimer, and I'm gonna post some money directly from our gains in the middle of the February, when I have the resubs, when I have the enough money, and then I'll get camera for PlayStation as well. Shirin, face come here, loss, and thank you, bro. Please, guys, try to comment in English. We need international audience, and from there on, eventually, we may force them to learn some nice words in Azerbaijan as well. Your commenting in English brings more views, brings more watches. Okay, I go. So far I like the game. It's not bad. There is a little bit exploration, over-exploration, or I'm playing it slow. But it's not bad, visually it's not bad, it's not glitching, and I only paid like £5 to get this game on discount. I'm using Xbox Turkey, and prices in Turkey is crazy cheap. Oh, I'm going to get there. Okay, I'm gonna go there from here. I guess. Let me get my light open. There is nothing here. Okay, we go. Okay. By the way, this is one of the myths that you can walk along the ventilation routes. They are not big enough to accommodate the people. All the things you are seeing in Die Hard in other films actually cannot be happening in real life. It's just one of the cinematic myths. Okay, this is hold up change. I unlock the door. I open the door. And where are we now? We came to exact same place again. Alright, I go from this side this time. There is nothing here. No. I go back. I go from outside then. Ah, this is the way. We are going to crush the wall. No, we are not able to crush the wall. How am I going to get from here? No, it doesn't work. No. So there should be another way to go through. Let me look around. We have door here. It's right behind us. Over there, we enter it here. We open up the door. Maybe there is an alternative route over here. I ain't sure. Okay, we come here. Ah, pipe grenade. This is exactly what we need to go and blow up the wall. Okay. Inventory, skills, quest, offensive item. Okay, I need to put it somewhere. I have no idea how to. Okay, I select this one. Remove from the shot. I remove. I select this one. Assign to the slot. I remove. No. I don't want to remove it from the slot. Okay, this is offensive item. Now I need to. Okay, this is it. Clever. Sometimes I think I'm slowly getting old for this shit, guys. Nah. Okay, here we are. We are back on the route. And we are moving. No other comments so far. Okay, we go. Check the resistance outpost. Find tools for Ryan. Alright, destroy plasma storage. We will. Okay. Alright. There is another fucker over there. Okay, now we are getting pretty used to it. We go from this way. We explore further. I think there is a little bit deficit of enemies. Enter the factory. Okay, I cannot leave the area. I think I'm exploring it too much. How do you see future for Twitch? My future or general Twitch future? Could you please elaborate, dear Seifosh? Ah. we gonna destroy this? Yes, we did destroy this one. And there should be another post around. The interesting thing, game doesn't give you any tips about anything. When you're stuck, it doesn't show you what to do. I'm not sure do I like it or no. Okay, general, for me this is not a bad initiative. I like playing games. I love Tolkien, you know it very well, Zephosh. I like the fact that this can be okay. There are a lot of them actually this time. Armored spider. I'm gonna use grenade to see how it works. Doesn't really work. Spider, where are you? You see, AI is a bit stupid. I will wait unless this big spider is there, and then I will blow out the plasma. I'm too late. I'm too late anyway. Fuckers are too strong. So Twitch is not bad initiative for me, but overall this is one of the things like vines. It's there, after sometimes it will not be there. Because people tend to get fed up of everything for a while. Could you imagine that in 2013 when Facebook is booming that we will stop using it significantly and we will not almost do anything on Facebook because we had Instagram, and now there is a TikTok. Okay, most of us here in this chat doesn't use TikTok a lot, but come on, now there is a TikTok. There was a Vine culture 4 second videos like for couple of years. It was booming. Now that company is done. It rebranded, it changed name, everything. Voila! Wow! Big Jeff. It changed name, rebranded, and Vine is gone. Look at the YouTube. YouTube is struggling now. Amount of the ads on YouTube is awful. I mean, if you are not YouTube premium user, you are just exposed to ads all the time. And it really bores you. You cannot even listen to one single in a proper way. It's always adding because people don't watch YouTube anymore. TikTok is killing YouTube, and Twitch is gonna be a similar platform. For now it's good. My main intention to get some new people to... I have no ammo and I have to run. Okay, just to get some new people on board, to meet new people, to do some charity with support of the people. Okay, now what I'm gonna do, I have no idea. Let me see, do we have any other stuff here? Okay, no bullets. Nothing. No bullets. So I basically have to run now. I have no other option but to run. Let me heal. So it will die, say Fosh, as everything does. Fuck you. I cannot kill the Scott drone like this, I'm gonna die. Okay, he just called me fuckhead. Beautiful. Oh my god, I'm gonna die, and I died. Eventually. Okay, we have 8 people. Seifosh, one of the best users ever. We have new subscriber today, Sadomazo, he joined us. Thank you very much, Mr. Sadomazo. We have good activities. Guys, are you seeing ads? How they are? Do they bore you? Is there overexposure to ads? Let me just quickly check my phone to see. Is there any other activities? Слишком много дивара. Okay. Ilyas, is it good now? Okay. There's a comment that video is a bit far. What should I do? If I stand closer, I will become probably blind. Is it better, guys, like this? I should move camera to closer, somewhere here. Next time I will try to use a chair. And we will see, because my screen is quite big. Okay, nah, what's nah? Parviz, why don't you mount the camera to the wall? I may, but not this time. This is a first trial. I may try to mount it somewhere. I am having some space issues as well, you know. So, I just died. I need to play more wisely this time. But how wise I can be? I have to destroy these things. I have very limited ammo, so I need to do something smarter. It's 1, 2, 3. What I'm going to do, I have no idea, but it should work smarter. So I have to blow the container. This is a robot, these are the little stuff. He doesn't see me. Okay, I'm here. Maybe we have got some ammo over here. I'm being exposed. So why don't you mount the wall? Okay, Pervis, that was the last comment. I'll do it, brother. But not now. Big Jeff. I need ammo. More ammo to fight. Otherwise, it's gonna be a nightmare for me. But I'm only getting like supplies and I don't really know how to use them now. Question to the audience. Okay, from 1 to 5, how do you rate Farid's game performance? That's a good question. I would rate it like 3. But I'm trying to communicate, guys. Maybe that's why I'm so bad.
Or
I am bad in general, I don't know. That's why the guy on the radio keeps calling me a fuckhead. Okay, the another guy. Fuck you. This one is done. Someone is shooting at me, spiders. These little guys are very annoying. Another one. Oh! There's another one over here. Is the next one. Question to the audience. Okay, audience is free to respond. Okay, there's another one. We are almost dead. I'm detected again. Fucking hell. Okay, now I need to heal. I need to be much smarter this time. I need more ammo. That's actually good. That gives you a vibe of the Terminator. Guys, Pervis is waiting for answer. People, Daftan, Seifosh, are you here, guys? Considering the take that the non-stop, focus. If I focus, it's gonna be 5. Come on. That's the point. You cannot focus and do all the things in parallel. Look, I'm trying to read and I'm trying to run. Fucking Skynet. Ah, that's how it's blasting flames to you. That's why I lose extra life. Ammos. Okay, I have only 17 bullets. Now it's gonna be a dogfight again. I need more ammo. Okay, here are ammos. That's good. Maybe I will grab simple pistol just to use ammo efficiently this time. No guards, not a good sign. Okay, there is a response from Seifosh. Mama, what is this? Let me talk to mom to see if she's around. But visuals are amazing, guys. Gameplay itself is not bad, controls are good, but I think there is a little bit clunkiness about some stuff. Okay, I can craft bullets, that's what I have to do, and I crafted it. Good. So that's where you craft the bullets, that was my mistake previously. Skynet activity, keeping eye on the hospital. Okay.
They must have moved on to that hospital. Alright, so I've got it. What's the status on that factory?
Your lockpicking skills are bad? Come on!
Shit.
the rules of survival. One quest is completed, but why my lockpicking skills are bad? Gee, I cannot produce anything else. I need like something like a shotgun for bigger activities. Metal scraps. Alright, here we are. We go further, fabrics. Okay, trade resources. Now I'll try to play better, just to show off that I'm a good gamer. I'm old, but I'm still good. I'm old, but I'm good. Oh yeah, baby. Okay, we go back. Explosive canister. Ah, this is the canister. This is what we need to shoot at, because it will explode. Oh! It explodes. Okay, what else? Bürcülere inanırsan. What kind of question is that? No? Not too sure. Sometimes, maybe. What kind of question is that? I'm a lion, by the way. Okay, one drone is gone. Here's the another one. Critical hits, baby, and he's gone. Energy cells. I need all the supplies now because I have to craft bullets. And I only have like very, very limited stuff again. NASA diyor ki bu il şirinler için uğurlu olacak. NASA. Okay, that's good. Again, type in English, brother. International audience, we go global, stuff like this. You know how it works. By the way, guys, talking about global, if you want some nice IT tips, how to make your computer life easier, you are more than welcome to join initiative done by Mr. Hajiev. It's called Cyber Perspective, and it's gonna give you a lot of good life hacks. Parviz, I suggest you to put the link below so that people can use your initiative as well. And I'm giving you free advertisement over here because I'm a lion and I like to share. Okay, there are still some side objectives. I'm gonna destroy that storage. I have to destroy that storage. It becomes personal. Tools for Ryan, I'm not gonna do that, but I will destroy that storage. Reklamlar, right. Cyber Perspective. Join the channel, enjoy the greatness while you can, guys. Okay, this is clunky part. Look, you jump and you don't go over. This is something which should not be in the games anymore, but they still do it. This is semi-independent publisher, we don't blame them. If they don't do it, who else will? Okay, there is another armored spider. Alright. Here's the scenery. I have to go there. I have to kill them all. I have to complete the side quest. Lighting is amazing, guys. Okay, fucking hell, I have no bullet. I have actually. I have the bigger one. Here we are, bro. Trill is gone. Stability and bullets. Can anas, can anas ana kurban. Mamul, I love you. You know what does it mean. Люблю тебя, Анюля. Guys, here's the comment from the queen herself. My mom, my biggest supporter. She doesn't understand the shit, but she's still there because I told her if you're gonna be rich, very simple. Chaka said she's just supporting me and I made her buy 6 months subscription as well. That's why a little bit I'm thinking of myself like now a little Ponzi because I'm doing this stuff, but I believe without it in this competitive content creation you have no option. So you have to do it. Let me see there. Okay, we have 6 people online. Critical hits, critical hits. And my mom is there. Alright. So should I keep doing it with Cam? Or should I just stream because this camera is slightly tougher? Alright, you know what? I'm gonna leave the side quest because it's becoming too much for me. I'm becoming consumed. And I have very little ammo. I get stability but nothing else. And they are just killing me all over. Hasta la vista, baby. Cuckoo. So now my lock picking level is too low. Alright. So we will just go there and forget about the side quests because I'm getting bored with this thing. We will just do the main mission. So Pervis, bürtüleri inanırsan. Seven people online, good streaming. Again, there are no comments about ads, how it's going. I don't want to have you guys to be exposed to over ads. I want to keep it stable. Okay, some ads are good for non-subscribers, but it should be on sufficient level so that you guys don't go away. Now let's focus on the game until we have a response from Pervis. They are surprisingly accurate. Are they accurate? That's the point. Sometimes, you know, we think that they are accurate because I read a study and I actually did it. If you say that I'm gonna check your future, I'm gonna do some foreseeing, you say 10 things and 6 out of 10 is right about the person, because linearly we are all having similar life, and for human it's very easy to connect the things happening around. I don't think that they are accurate. Maybe they are, or maybe they are too generic and we all know from where we can grab something personal to us. You know what I mean? Okay, we go up, we go further. Nothing here, too much exploration, too little action. This is old change room. There is something. Okay. They are killing Colin.
Talk to me, Colin.
If they are killing Colin, that means they are around. Should I go and help that ass-face Colin? I don't think so. But I am talking about personality traits. Personality traits, actually right. They are quite accurate. I don't know how. But there is a relation, and if you study the numerology with numbers, Colin, shit, who is this? What happened to me? He just kicked me out. And Colin is dead. Is it a robot? Oh, this is a Terminator. This is a new model with cyber skin. This is cyber perspective of Skynet on their models. Again, I'm telling you, with right numerology, it is possible. And from religious, from science perspective, you can theoretically do it. Do I believe in it in a greater extent? No. But it is something there. Jacob, wake up, Jacob. So I have been marked for termination. That means I'm one of the guys who is on priority list of the Skynet.
Hours later, they found me lying in front of our hideout.
Very close to the film, particularly the second film. We have narration of the Sarah.
Colin's dead. And the stranger I saw is nowhere to be found.
Of the Terminator.
I told them about everything.
Safe for
I said
are
that
you
it wasn't
here?
Safe for them to be with me.
Can you answer
but
the question,
Jennifer
please?
Suggested that right now, nowhere is safe. So we might as well stick together. Everyone pulled through as we prepared for the worst. But nothing happened.
Okay. I think right now Cam is good. I will vault it over. mounted over later on. Okay, this is a Patrick, the guy we decided to save.
Not that long. I know that you're going to that hospital today, so I went on my first scavenging run.
Okay, little kid. Just one bullet, thank you very much.
No. As soon as Erin heard that there's a hospital nearby, she asked Jennifer to go look for some medicine.
Okay, Jennifer is going after medicines.
Don't tell her that. Okay.
She's already.
Say, for she's not much into the zodiacs.
And Ryan wanted to talk to you.
Ryan wanted to talk to me. Basically, in this level, nothing significant happened. Nothing. That's the first drawback of the game. It looks good, but nothing happened. Where's Colin? Colin is dead. Talk to her. This is Erin, our doctor.
Came to me earlier, asking if I thought you'd like his present. When I saw that it was a single bullet, I wasn't sure if he was being helpful.
Okay. Pervis is late November. He's Legolas. I know it. I figured he'd appreciate you looking at his sister like this. What kind of sorbet is this? Okay, what we should ask? How's Mark doing?
Not great. We barely have any medicine left.
What? But you are. And you are October. You are Scorpion. Sorry. You are Scorpion. I know it.
How do you feel about Colin's death?
Forget the questions. They are very stupid. People don't talk like this. Why am I asking
right
it? I don't
now,
even
I'm
know.
A little more concerned with the living than the dead.
Old lady has perfect teeth, by the way. We don't have too space to clean our teeth, but look at her teeth.
Do you need help with anything?
No, I'm fine.
Okay.
I had to learn to do things by myself.
She's fine.
Quite a while, sweetie.
She has got beautiful
tell
eyes.
Me what did you really
look
want
at the
to
design
ask me?
Of her hair. The depth of field is bad. That's one of the issues when you have cheaper developer.
How did you know about the annihilation?
Too many questions.
I heard the rumors like everyone else. And then, like everyone
what's Seyfosh sign? Seyfosh is. How do you call it? What's Seyfosh sign? Seyfosh, are you here?
I realized that we were surrounded. The machines killed most of us. Decided to keep me alive.
Yeah, Seyfosh can be an AI. There is a possibility. Some guys thinking of Seyfosh be another guy. I know identity of Seyfosh. But not gonna share it with you guys.
Who else was in that camp with you?
The questions doesn't bring anything. I don't like it. They don't change the story.
There were up to
nothing.
10 people squashed together inside.
They are up to 10 people, so they are almost dead. Okay, I'm gonna finish one more level and then disconnect for today. Pretty much good audience.
First person that wasn't afraid to ask. They're all scared of me, like I'm carrying some sort of disease.
Okay, lady's carrying sort of disease.
Ironic, isn't it?
She doesn't feel happy. Okay, I leave. I'm tired of Erin's bullshit. There's a pool table. Okay, where do we leave? From where we leave?
Arr, take that,
Patrick.
You don't stand a chance. Arr.
Okay, Patrick is doing something nasty over. This is Ryan, one of the elders in the group.
Good to see you finally turn the corner. I wanted to talk to you. I'm starting to get worried about Jennifer.
Mm-hmm.
It's been a while since she left, and at my age,
I guess we are going to head to the hospital.
See her out there? Send her back, okay?
Projection in which direction, bro? Okay, I'll do it. I don't want to talk to Ryan. Quest updated. We go to hospital now. To save the Jennifer. Political, economic. I'm gonna make a good video on that one. Basically, I don't see, let's say, big international change after this Gaza situation and overall Ukrainian-Russian conflict. I think rest of the year will be quite steady, but economically I think there will be some further layoffs, particularly in investment business, in financial sector, because AIs like possibly say Forge are making people's sport less and less secure. So it is quite expected that real Skynet is not going to use nuclear bombs, but it will just take our jobs away and we will start to eat each other. Why not? Because population should go down, so that in 30 years there are new businesses to increase the population again. That's how a system works. That's how it worked with Alexander and his father Philip. So it's pretty much the same thing. Is it Jennifer? Yes.
It's bad enough with those creepy noises.
Creepy noises.
Every once in a while, there's this unbearable scream coming from that hospital. We need to see what's going on. Let's move.
Let's see what's going on. Let's move. So now we will enter the hospital. Probably there are some Skynet guys over there.
Voila.
Look at his hands, they are very well worked. It looks like used, uncleaned hands, which gives a realistic view to the judgment, not like a tease of the Aryan, which looked quite perfect. On Ukrainian front, I think there will be some peace treaties to some extent in favor of Russia, and then it will stop for a while. Then amount of sanctions will increase at once, but eventually they will be stabilized because they have to stop a couple of the conflicts, or it will not bring any further money to the parties. On the other hand, yesterday I read a news that NASA is urging Europe to go for full-scale war with Russia. I'm not sure how reliable is that source, because every day you are reading so many different things. They are contradicting and you cannot trust any source. On your preference, you get what you want to see. That's what we are being fed via our news feed, via AIs who are processing our data, so I'm not really sure. But I hope war stops. I hope people don't die anymore. Steven Spielberg was one of my idols, but I see how he's not reacting or supporting the Israel actions in Palestine now. I see that. Okay, he's not a really good man. This is not a soul. By mind, he can make a Schindler's List. But by soul, he is quite a little fascist himself, because no normal person can back up the fact that right now children are dying and we are not taking any actions. Nothing is happening, come on. Ben Affleck is one of the only, one of the only celebrities who supports the conflict resolution in a good way, but on the other hand, Ben Affleck is also brainwashed after Argo. He has different view of the Muslims in general. So I'm not sure. Till when it will continue, I think till the elections, and then it will end. After then the elections, probably, not sure. Let's hope it ends till the elections, like in 2 months. Because in 1 month it's gonna be exact year that how all this conflict started. Exactly 2 years, actually, and this is a quite a long time, quite a long leap. Okay, ouch, fuckers, I'm dead. So they are leaping. That is why till March probably there should be a treaty. I hope there will be a treaty, but again, today's world, everything can change, so not sure anymore. Okay guys, I'm a bit tired, I'll go to saving point and then turn off for today. I think that's enough. I'm gonna continue playing Terminator.
Right now, we'll try to get some questions.
Other relevant topics next time. Or I'll just play. I want to finish one game before shifting to others, so that we have a certain level of people who are following the game.
Hello?
Okay, so when they start to turn, you shoot them, not before. Okay. I'm out of ammo and I had only one bullet. Beautiful! Basically, I have nothing. Come here, come here. I'm too late. I need ammo. I urgently need ammo. Or they will kill me again. Or I will try to sneak around to some ways. Alright. Okay. Ah! Fuckers. You run. Maybe I jump over something higher and they don't reach to me. Ah, no, they are reaching to me and they are killing me. Okay, from checkpoint, let's give it one more try. Loading times are amazing. It takes you like 5-10 seconds to fully get reloaded.
Right now, you need to start answering some questions.
Okay, so if I try to do. Oh, actually, I can. No, I cannot craft anything here. Maybe there is other way, because I don't know how to pass by these little fuckers.
Hello?
We get the trade material, we get everything. Okay, we have still 6 people, that's an amazing number. But we need real ammo, and we don't get it, we just get the stuff, which are not really useful right now. So I need to be very, very smart, they don't detect me. Okay, so how am I gonna be that smart? I have no idea how to pass over this stuff. Okay, it's seeing me actually, still seeing me. Okay, I stop. I do one turn, I use the other side. No, no ways here. Nothing here. I came again to this location. Look, maybe there we had something, but I'm not able to open it. I have no, but absolutely no bullets. Okay, what we have got here? We have nothing. Okay. So I can improve some weapon skills, more damage, more stuff, archives. Okay, I carry on. But with amount of the stuff I have got, it's gonna be a nightmare to do it. Okay, silverfish. It's still not effective, but it can work if I hit them on right moment with this. It can work. Let's try it. Come, baby. No, it doesn't work at all. Not a good idea. And I have no defensive things to drill. Anything. Silverfish, one is there. Okay. We crawl. We lay down. We go. There is one over there. Oh, someone is screaming. Ah! Fuck. What can. Okay, I'm gonna throw the bombs this time. My performance is like becoming too right now. It's getting worse and worse.
You!
I left you a hacking device. It's in the basement of a building off the main street.
Okay,
it will help you go inside that hospital.
This is my last plan. Okay, first one is done. I have a couple of bombs, so I'm gonna use them. I'm gonna get the stuff from here. Trade material. Okay, this one is done. That one is not interesting. Okay, we crawl, we crawl. We crawl. We are silent. Assassin mode is on. There is two over here. Kill this silver fishes. Ah! Fucking hell, I'm an idiot. Okay, this is very last time I try, guys. I'm tired. I'm tired and I cannot pass it. I didn't expect this to be this hard, but I actually like the fact that it's very exploration driven. Gives you a feeling of survival, and it's actually good. Okay, we grab the stuff again.
Hello?
We go from there. We have silverfish over there. Alright. Let's give it one more try. If I didn't behave like an idiot last time, I could pass by it. One swordfish is there. Again, same voice. Okay, there is no swordfishes here. Actually, there is one, but I am undetected for now. I actually missed the fucking target, man! I can't believe it. It's... okay, it's done. It's not done. If I run there, it should be it. Yes! Finally! But I used like extensive ammo. All the grenades. Thank you for I have to leave the chat. Okay, no worries, stuff done. Thanks for the sub you did, brother. Thank you for your time and for your comments. Hope you enjoyed it. I know I suck right now, a bit, but you know, I'm a good gamer, I'm gonna fix it. Okay, there is a hacking device. Now we can sound decoy, is a high frequency that okay, that's interesting. That's exactly what I needed to run away from the guys. Okay, we crafted the stuff, we don't have ammo, but that's fine, that's fine. Let's hope we have some electrical parts here. Totally useless, but still, they can work. Alrighty. This is the door. These are the two locations. And we go further? No, we don't actually. There is an exit over here. I go here. I check. There's another door. But why my lockpicking skills are too low? What should I do to improve it? Craftable, I have like 6. Maybe I need to get skills for lockpicking. Okay, now it should be visual detection, more damage, explosive. Okay, there is science, lockpicking, that's how you improve it. Crafting, hacking, and survival, toughness. Okay, I got it now. Now my lockpicking should be fine. Here we are, babies. Okay. I broke one of the stuff. I broke the second stuff. I'm an idiot. I broke another one. Ah! What's happening? Wait. Okay. I'm wasting all my logs, literally. Let's see the tutorial. Okay, to rotate the pin at the same time. Correct angle. Yeah. That's becoming stupid. Look at that. Ah! That's stupid. Let me get. I cannot craft anything. We are out of ammo, we are out of stuff. And I feel like we are stupid. I couldn't lockpick anything. Now what we gonna do? We gonna try to survive over again. Okay. Ah! Oh, it works. If you hit them before they jump, it worked. No, not you, not you, bro. Blow. Now I have to run again. No defensive items. I have literally nothing. I think we passed away from that one, but I'm still detected actually. I have to run. And it's getting out of hand. It's really getting out of hand. I kinda start to feel that I'm totally fucked. Yes, we go. Another raider.
I could control those turrets with the hacking device.
Okay, there's a hacking device and I can control the turrets. Maybe I should go for it. If I can control the turrets, that can actually work. No. He's going to detect me very soon. Oh my god. How the hell I'm gonna hack it? Okay, what we have to do to hack that? You must right side of you while avoiding the... to move your icon. Okay, so I have to run. Okay, I think I'm getting it. Okay. Ah! Fuck. I should be in the middle, so up, down. Ah, finally. It's ours now. Beautiful. Okay, another hacking. This one's very easy. But I keep dying. I feel like an idiot, man. Okay. Okay, now it's better. My performance is going down to 2. Another turret, and I have no ammo, nothing. Someone is again shooting at the distance. I'm not detected, come on. I'm detected. I'm not in a good state. And this guy is my only hope to protect me right now. It's becoming tense. Is it? I didn't even say feel it. It is long. Probably it's 1 hour 40 minutes. As soon as I reach the safe location, I will stop because I'm really consumed and I'm really tired. Because this game is actually kinda different than I expected. It has got a lot of exploration, a bit more than it should be. It has got some survival element and I actually like it. Okay, there is a plasma turret. We're gonna hack it now. Okay, now I got it. I almost got it, I meant. Here we are! Now, kill the other one! Kill that fucker! Good! They're gonna toy with each other. Here we are! Beautiful! My stuff still has some life. So I think I am never ready for working week, brother. I have never been and I will never be. That's why I'm streaming. I think no one's ready for working, no matter what your compensation is. Freedom is coming with not working, first of all. I will never be ready for work, but it's gonna be tough work. I'm gonna travel to Sheffield, some other things to be done. It promised to be quite interesting. And are you ready, Mr. Hajiev? Ah, I'm again detected. We have some grenades over there, I think we can use it. So what we have got here? Okay. I have like 3 of them and they are... I can drop them? No, they are for now, they are fine, but it's nothing. Ammunition for shotguns, but we don't have shotguns. There's a Vulcan guy over there, so I have to be very careful with that one. It's just behind me. Minigun. Armored spider. Okay, now I have to hack that plasma turret so that it can kill the other guy. Okay, that was smart. It's still out of my reach for hacking, but the other guy is coming. Now I have to hack you very, very quickly. Okay. Here we are. Now kill them. Kill the fuckers. Good boy. Now you should kill the spider first. Okay, this one is done. Oh my god, it's here. Okay, arm is focused, you should get it, bro. Smart, I like it. I like hacking the stuff and I finally got ammo. Alright, we go further. This is hospital, these are the stuff. Again, someone is screaming, that creepy. Dear Maria, there is a note. Okay. Exterminated, thanks for coming. Okay, should we open this one? Maybe there is something. Fabrics. Alright. Where we can save this game? I need a saving point. Maybe they are experimenting with the people, huh? There has to be something who is hurting the people. Let's heal up. We heal. Oh! Something is dragging them, fuck's sake. Okay. I healed up. Famous Terminator voices. This is Robert Patrick from Terminator 2. That's how they got his skin. That's
the others have to be here too.
Amazing. I mean, that's amazing. Asterisk. So this Easter egg is Robert Patrick. I need to make a screenshot of it. Wait. How do you take the photo? Screenshot saved. This is incredible Easter egg. I loved it. So that's how they are going to create 2000. This is part of their research center, Skynet Research Center. 2000 is the main villain of Terminator 2, played by great Robert Patrick. By the way, Robert Patrick also played a part in Die Hard. Okay, medkits. I have no stuff to break the pins. Screenshot uploaded. I should go for. This is very famous Terminator notes we are hearing. Oh my god! It's right over there. Okay, T-8000, it's gone. Oof, it's good. It's also tense, man. There's another one over here. It's coming to me! I think I almost got detected. No, not yet. Oops! Two more fuckers. Again, no lock pins. Okay, we run from this side. No supplies over here. The lights, the atmosphere of Terminator, it's really good. Lasers, another guy. I'm gonna hide here. Okay, here is he, another T-800. One of them is gonna catch me. There's no chance that I can run away from them all the time. They're gonna get me. I don't know, is it part of the game, but I have really no resources and it makes it exciting.
So someone's coming.
Okay, it's a resistance soldier. Hey guys.
Private Jacob Rivers, Pacific Division.
Pacific Division.
What the hell happened up there? The whole division went silent.
It was wiped out. I'm the only one who survived, and I need to
check the chat.
Baron.
All right, I'll make sure you get to do that. But first, get us out of here. Follow that staircase. It'll lead you to the main generator. Overload it and turn off the laser grid.
Understood.
And Rivers,
understood.
Destroying that generator will make a lot of noise. So in case we get separated, where are you stationed?
Just south from here.
Okay. We'll find you. Baron will want to meet you. Now go, and watch out for those metals.
Okay, watch out for those metals. Oh, finally some supplies. I just need... Oof! More guns now. Alright. Alright. I need to turn down the generator. Then it should be fine. So where is that generator? It's right over there. There is no Skynet around. No, there are a couple of Skynet guys around, actually. This is going to be a challenge. This is going to be a big challenge. Okay, I can hack something. This is for Dora, I guess. Okay, first part is done. Second part. Okay, this time I'm not so bad. If I could use a stones or whatever, that would be actually good. Okay, it's behind the wall. I like the fact that confrontation is very tough with this guy. It makes game interesting. Another hacking stuff. Okay. We go. Okay. Guys, why you are not living? Why you are there? What kind of beard do you use? Looks sick. What? It's normal one. Oh my god. Now I have to hide away from this guy. The AI is stupid, come on. Look how I'm hiding away. But it's like becoming so fast. Okay, I hit here. How the hell I'm gonna kill this fucker? Weapons are ineffective, thank you for that. I have nothing to use against. Can be the only way to deceive this fucker. I'm gonna deceive you, fucker. Okay, it's there. Come here, come this side. Cuckoo! Come this side. Can I hack it? So? He still feels my presence. Go away, bro. And chance to hack it? No, no chance to hack it. He knows I'm here. He just doesn't move. We have very limited stuff. Bro, calm this side. Calm this side and I try to run. Fucker. Can I hack you, please? Yeah, I can hack you actually. No, I cannot hack. Okay, we are done. Alright, I think that's it for today, guys. Almost 2 hours. Thank you all for joining. That's a tough game. We will come back to it for sure. Have a nice evening. Thank you for your time. Thank you for your participation and comments. Stream to you later. And I hope you enjoyed my ugly face.